this information in mind, we can proceed to take the Diffie-Hellman key exchange as we have seen it with finite fields and use it with elliptic curves. So if you remember, the Diffie-Hellman problem was the following. You have a element G, which is a generator, and an attacker only sees g to the power of x and g to the power of y. Can this attacker compute g to the power of xy? And in order to compute that, he would have to compute the discrete logarithm, right? So we can restate this as the elliptic curve Diffie-Hellman problem. Given a point g, and g generating a large group, and the attacker has the access to the scalar multiplication of x and g and y of g, can the attacker actually compute x times y of g? In order to compute that, you would have to compute the discrete logarithms on elliptic curves, which is even more difficult than on finite fields. So we can use that to build the so-called elliptic curve Diffie-Hellman key exchange, which works exactly the same as the finite field version, just that now the secret exponent is a scalar that is used for scalar multiplication, and then the public value is sent to the opposing side. The other side does the exact same computation with another random secret scalar and sends that value. And now a secret point can be computed, since the first party knows their secret scalar. They can use the public value of the other side and add their secret scalar to the public value, capital B, and get a scalar multiplication result that corresponds to a secret point. And the other side does exactly the same, computes the secret point, and then both have agreed on a secret point that can be used as key material, and somebody who observed the public values is unable to compute this secret key material. And we can use that key material to compute keys for encryption. So this is exactly the same protocol, the same thing as finite field Diffie-Hellman, right? So why do we even bother doing elliptic curve things instead of directly using finite fields? And I've already mentioned that earlier, with elliptic curve crypto, you can just have much smaller keys. So this value that is transmitted here is much smaller than if you would have used it with finite fields, if you would have used finite fields. So that's it.